don't know who we are, my name's Kenny Mandryk. I'm from Thunder Bay, Ontario.
Colby Reed from Thunder Bay, Ontario.
I'm Christoph.
Like you said, my name's Kenny. I'm 22 years old. Been racing dirt bikes for 19 years now, since I was 3, and snowcross since I was 18. So this will be my 4th full season. We race the ISOC Nationals sport class. We try hard, and the main thing is we just like to have fun. So far this year, our luck has not been the greatest. Hey, 2020 is a new year. Maybe this year you guys can follow along with us and we'll have some more fun.
So the last 4 years I've been in school for engineering. That's a lot of schedule, I guess, busy with that. But tried to do my best to go along every race. Basically, my weekend looks like tuning the sled and fixing what he breaks. Duluth and Fargo, it's been a lot of carnage, but we've been getting through. We'll see how Shakopee goes, I guess.
That's our comedy man there, Circus Junior.
The real circus ain't here. His name's J.O. A lot of you guys might know him, a lot of you guys might not, but he's usually the entertainment for the weekend. He usually hops in with us and comes with us from race to race. On another note is, I had something, but I don't know. So normally we go race to race in my truck, and we got a trailer, a 40-foot gooseneck trailer that the sleds and the quad and everything, and we sleep in the trailer. We're at the track 24/7, so sometimes it can get frosty and cold, and but you know, it's nice atmosphere. I like waking up at the track and being ready to go every morning. But right now we don't have my truck because somebody burnt it. So right now we are using this 2002 Duramax that one of my local sponsors lent us to use for the weekend. It ain't pretty, but we'll get us there, and that's all that matters. You know, we don't have a fancy rig, or we're not factories. We're just out here to have some fun. So yeah, about this truck, we are on the road now. We're on our way to ERX for the day. It's January 1st, by the way. Happy New Year's, everybody. We're gonna go practice for the day before we head to Shakopee in the morning. This truck that we're driving, we basically pulled it out of the snowbank yesterday and had to do a bunch of work and clean it out because it is a work truck. Let's just go back a little bit since before we left and take a look around and what we had to go through.
Gotta do what you gotta do, I guess.
It's our rig for the weekend.
Hopefully don't rip the D-tank hose off, but we got no door handles, brand new tires, brand new mirrors just hanging on, just nice. The best part about this truck.
Need a pry bar now.
Oh, you got a silicone in there.
There you go.
Oh yeah.
Can't try the window now. No.
Just hit the road. Just started. First of all, we got no fucking heat.
What do you think, Colby?
Junk.
We'll make it there.
Get on the two-way. Listen to this thing purr. Going through the small town of Two Harbors. See this place many times through the year. It's part of our one-way road.
Usually slamming on brakes for fucking idiots like this every fucking time. Anyways. Pulling on people, pulling on in front of us every time pisses me off. Especially when a truck with no fucking brakes. Anyways, we sit back and take turns driving. Christopher drives usually more than I do, but Christopher's usually on night shift. Isn't that right, Christopher?
Yeah, but I mean, so far this year we've been good. We've all been close.
I've been trying to do my part and keep up on the driving. We just talk about weekend and what we have to do. Goals for the weekend and what we think we're gonna break this weekend, predictions on what's gonna happen. Then once we get to the track, we're usually basically asking questions to each other on, is the generator gonna start? Do we have enough propane? Is our thermostats gonna work? Just a bunch of shit that always say, why us? Like, why does this always happen? But looking forward to another great weekend at Shakopee. Nothing can beat this, right? Could be at home sitting on the couch, but it's way better. Old LBZ's got just as much power as a brand new L5P.
Right.
Wrong lane.
Buzzing out. I am floored right now. Shit, gotta go all the way around to the other fucking side. Welcome.
America.
America.
Perks of this 02 LBZ. Nice leather interior. Oh, what do you know? You gotta let them in. No door handles.
No door handles. Both sides. Driver side and passenger side. No door handle. But we're back on road. Person just cut us off.
No wonder.
No fucking wonder you got no bumper or his rear quarter panel. Like, no wonder. Just pulling into Elk River. Circus is sleeping.
Made it here to ERX. Stammy whammy.
You got driving. What are you driving? Fucking J.O.'s garbage truck.
Well, should we unload the trailer?
We broke this time.
Jenny's fucking crooked.
Upside down.
Boots. That's just nice. Guess we're gonna find out if Jenny's in the start.
Holy fuck. First try? Chugging a little bit.
This fucker's got a million hours on her.
Every weekend it just seems to get better and better on fuel. Just wrapped up practice at ERX. We got here at like 3 o'clock, 3:30. It's now 7:30. Haven't been on the sled for a few weeks, so it's nice to be able to finally get out there and shake the cobwebs off before Shakopee. In the Malo, doing some starts. Of course, we always break something. We got another broken reed. You can see through that guy right there. Christopher got that all changed up. Ready to go back out.
What?
What are you doing? You are ignorant, arsehole.
Just leaving ERX here, making our way to Canterbury this morning.
Warm out today. Hopefully the weekend kind of stays like this. We both didn't get a very good sleep last night. But
we're making her, and that's what counts. We even got a little warning light on this thing. Made it here.
Old trusty Duramax made it. Getting the truck wash done now.
Fucking people working on sleds here. Everyone all lined up. Pull up beside Lugard there.
We just got all parked here. Canterbury Park. Got a pretty good spot this weekend. Staging's just gonna be up over here. We got Casey.
What up?
You look like a Mexican.
Why? Am I dark?
You're dark.
Sam trying to park now. Trying to squeeze in front of us. What the fuck is he doing? Can't block the lane, you dumb fuck.
Go, it's J.O.
You can't block the lane.
Can't block the lane here. You gotta park in front of us. Fucking man.
Check out our chalk job here. We got little beats plywood. 2x6.
Door opens just straight.
What moved on the way here?
Is it Jenny upside down?
No, we're good this time. Well, going to unload the trailer. We got a little tangled up here. Okay, continue.
Yeah, just got all parked here. Gonna go for lunch. Gonna go to Jimmy John's. Apparently we're freaky fast. Maybe we'll be freaky fast this weekend. Shenanigans. Fucking dickhead.
A little bit of Jimmy John's.
Tyson.
Well, we upgraded our rubber now. A little flat neck action.
Turn that fucking air conditioning off.
What air conditioning?
Follow me.
Go to the buffet.
Is it open though tonight?
Oh yeah.
It's open. There's a,
yeah, stripper.
Okay, let's go.
Go on.
Do you have Mountain Dew?
Let's get a water, please.
Just put out another big pepperoni pizza.
Come to a buffet, and all this guy gets is pizza.
I'm gonna go up for a round of gummy bears, Christopher says. Let's follow him, let's see where he's going. Oh yeah, there you go.
Dig right in there, Christopher.
Oh yeah.
Look at Greg.
Oh yeah, oh yeah.
Christopher said the gummy bears were way too good. He said he needs another round. Taking the whole jar back to him.
Christopher's got the whole thing of gummies. Look at.
Come on, you can take them all because I gotta clean it up. You want them all? Yeah, can't take the jar. Sorry about that.
Thanks.
But if we just drive over this, we can go out that way, no?
Yeah.
Oh, this is wrong way.
Oh, yeah, this whole
you're gonna pull a U-E here.
Morning guys, Shakopee day one. It's Friday, it's race day. It's gonna be a great day. It's nice out. We're at the track nice and early. It's 8 o'clock. We've got a little bit of sled work to do this morning and practice starts at 11. We go talk to the man of the hour and see what he's got for us. A little bit of a present today. Juddy, you wanna be in our vlog?
Yep, here you go, Kenny.
Thank you.
God bless, see you in April.
Thank you. So a typical morning for us on race day is music blasted, a little bit of sled work, Colby and Christopher getting it dialed. What are you guys doing today? What are you doing, Christopher? What are you doing?
Ski loops.
Changing a ski loop, busted ski loop. Going up for round two. Round one wasn't good. Blew a reed in our first heat. Starting to snow pretty good out here now.
Well, second heat was better. Jumped a little bit on the start, but he didn't trip the beam. Light still went green, so he went, looked over, everyone else is going, but the starter guy's going by him saying, no, 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 whoa, whoa, whoa. Kept going, expecting there to be a red flag at the finish line, the restart start, and nothing. So ended up running second for a little bit. Made a mistake coming out of the one corner to the triple. Got third. Thought everything was good. Should be an LCQ. Go to look at the LCQ post and then we're dead last, 30th. So they scored us dead last in both heat races today. Went to tech, talked to them. They didn't have an answer for it. We went up to scoring. Basically, they told us, oh yeah, didn't you know they scored you guys all last because you're jumping under yellow. Nice way to find out about that. Just typical drama. Hey, Burba, what do you figure?
It's T-spot.
Just got off the track for LCQ, full hole shot in one, felt good. Finally, nice to be able to get out front for the day. You know, we had some rough day today, so nice to be able to, might only be the LCQ, but still feels good to be out front. Back row for final, we'll see where we land tonight.
Dude, it's like minus 10 outside. It's actually plus one.
Canadians, all the Canadians.
If I do,
you think Red Bull's better?
Oh, definitely.
Which color?
I prefer the red, definitely, over the green.
What jet? 460s?
Almost.
The flash
almost.
Off.
Vlog right now. You want to tell us what happened to your knee?
I actually don't know what happened yet, but it's I had an MRI and it's torn up a little bit, but I haven't seen a surgeon yet, so kind of waiting still to figure out exactly what's wrong.
Hopefully be back for Deadwood.
I don't know yet.
Not sure yet. Just living it day by day.
Yeah. So,
cool, man. Well, thank you. Caleb, tell me when you're going to race.
This year.
You're going to race this year? What are you going to race?
A 200.
You're going to race a 200? What kind? You don't know? Who's your sponsors? Who would you like to thank? Who else?
Mom, Dad, Grandma, Grandpa, brother, that's it.
That's it. Final complete for Friday night. Back row start. Kind of got pinched off on the start. That's racing kind of, I think I worked my way up to, I don't know, 9th maybe, 10th, I don't know. I mean, it felt like I rode all right, but tomorrow will be a new day.
Sleepy.
Day two here today. Christopher, what are you doing?
Tightening the chain a little.
Tightening the chain a bit. Just got some fresh shocks in today. We got 7th in the final last night. Not what we're looking for, but we got some weird smell going on in the trailer. Colby, what are you doing over here?
Spraying down his shoes with SC1.
Oh, why are these on the dryer?
That's what I wear to the line all day.
You wear those stuff in the snow? Spray some SC1 in there, make it smell good.
One of our newest helpers here, Mr. Polhill. Caleb, what are you doing?
Brushing all the snow off.
There you go. Too bad it's not a skidoo though, eh? What did you say?
Holy f***, that hurt.
I still see your shadows in my room. Can't take back the love that I gave you. It's to the point why I love and I hate you. And I cannot change you, so I must replace you. Oh, easier said than done. I thought you were the one listening to my heart instead of my head. You found another one, but I am the better one. I won't let you forget me.
How's that free pulled pork sandwich? Fucking mint! Now that's a fucking burger.
Huckle's the vlogger.
Fuck off!
Air Force hoodie.
Hoodie?
Yeah.
Join?
Join?
Kidding.
Can I get one?
Maybe. Let me see how many deck members we have. Right. And if we have enough, we'll see what we can do.
Sounds good, thanks.
Yep.
Row seating, fucking 69.
Don't fucking mind if I do. Don't mind if I do.
Calm before the storm.
Chunk fucking
mad. Yes, smoke another one, Mr. Hill.
Getting ready for final. Back row again, imagine that. At least we're in it.
Hey, sled ready?
Yes, sir.
What'd you change?
Reeds.
Hey, what's your last name?
Reed.
Huh?
Raiders Reed.
Imagine that.
Oh. Mr. Stinky in the flesh.
Well, got back to the final. I think we got sick. Rode good. Had a not so best start, but he managed to drive around a bunch of people. Happy with a sixth from going from the LCQ today.
Christopher, back at it again with the shoes.
Look at this. All day. Come on, dude. How do you even wear that?
Sunday here in Shakopee, we're just pulling out. Got our 6 hour drive back home. See if we make this corner. We had Stammy Whammy drive over the post here to Bender right over. Ah, look at this. Perfect. Would have made it without bending the post over, but Sammy Whammy did her anyways. Catch up with you guys once we're on the road.
Fuck the fence.
Yeah. Fuck the fence. Here you go.
Just on our way back from Shakopee, we're gonna try out Jackie Reese's from the Race Bakery's cookies. What do you think, Christopher?
Pretty good.
Good job, Jackie.
Trying to get home at a decent time, so
in the race.
Hoping the mirror don't fall off on the way home.
Pretty loose. Only one bolt holding it on.
Switch drivers on the way home.
Last night I come down with a pretty good head cold. I barely keep my eyes open right now. Christopher, what do you think of the dually?
Brakes are a little spongy.
Brakes are spongy. Hinkley, Minnesota, pulling out. Homebound.
Almost home from Shakopee. So just wanted to discuss over the weekend. Friday, blew a reed on the start. The sled was pretty much unrideable. So I putted around the back and just got points and ended up eighth. First heat, and then second heat came out and ended up with a third. Put us in the LCQ. I ripped the whole shot and won that. So put us first pick, back row, final. Friday night's final. It's okay. I didn't feel too great on the sled. I knew I had to work. I was pretty slow in the corners. I knew I gotta definitely work on that before Deadwood in 2 weekends. I ended up seventh Saturday morning. Ended up going off the track on the start and had a pretty bad crash. Bent my bars and couldn't turn the sled for the rest. So I had to wait and wait for the checker to cross the finish line again in eighth. Then the second heat, went over the finish line after the start and last. Put my head down and made my way to first and won that heat. Same thing, had to go through LCQ again. Made myself up to third. I blew another reed that one in the LCQ, but it was still rideable. I finished that LCQ in third. We were third pick, back row for final, which was the best place I've finished so far this year, which was fifth. I crossed the finish line on the first lap in 13th. I worked my butt off, man, and we caught our way back up to fifth. And so I felt good yesterday. I know where I need to improve. I know what I need to put in for these next 2 weeks before Deadwood. So hopefully we're gonna come out better than that. You know, maybe if we get a front row start for once, maybe we can land on that podium. I can taste it, so.
Sled was pretty good overall on the weekend other than blowing the reeds. I don't know if we had a bad batch of them because the set that blew was pretty much brand new. We only had a little bit on Sunday from the final in Fargo and a little bit of practice on it. So that one blew. That was on the PTO side. Put in a brand new set, a final, and a practice and a heat, and then that one blew in the second heat the next day. But that one was on the mag side. I don't know if it was just a bad batch of them coming out of the trailer or, I don't know, we talked to a few other people that were riding Polaris's and they were having problems with reeds this weekend too. So stay on top of it, I guess. Hopefully things turn around there because it kind of sucks when a reed blows because you really got no control.
control over it. First heats weren't the best out of the each day, but second heats you come back, bounce back, get in the LCQ, rode really good in those, got in the final, and then rode amazing in each final. So we know we got the speed, just need to start 10 feet further on the start line. And then maybe we can actually get on top of the box. Looking forward to Deadwood, do a little bit of testing on the sleds, work on corners and starts.
Yeah, that's another thing I need to work on too, is starts. Learned a lot already this year that I haven't been doing in the starts that are crucial. I gotta put those together, make it like it's in the back of my head, just like riding a bicycle, like you never forget it. We're gonna put our head down these next 2 weeks and see if we can come up for Deadwood.
Throw a tent, I anthem, turn it up and throw up in your Birkin bag. On this, that social awkward, lips and buy your likes. I sweat hit different when it's Thursday. Music every day like this.